What is up, YouTube? It's your girl Jada, and I'm back with another video. And today, basically, what I'm going to be... Whoa, now. Pause. Okay, my computer's going dead. Let's make this fast. Basically, what I was going to be doing today was just going to be responding to those girl talk topics that y'all sent me to my DMs. And just talking to y'all about what I'm doing with my life and what's going on right now. But... yeah, this is pretty much it. If you're new here, please like, comment, and subscribe. And if you're returning, welcome back. But basically, we just finna get into this video. Pretty random, pretty whatever. But I pretty much said that I already was gonna do this. So, let's get it. Lately, y'all, I've been busy. Like, if you don't know, I'm a senior in high school. I'm 17 years old. And I am basically just trying to figure out my life. You know, YouTube, everything is going good for me YouTube-wise. But academically and, you know, further from what I'm doing here, I'm just in a weird headspace. I feel like senior year is so stressful, and I feel like everything that you want to handle, make sure you handle early in time. Like, don't wait to the last minute, because then you're going to be stuck. And, y'all, I'm stressing about everything right now. But we're going to try and, you know, see what's, you know, we're going to try and leave that alone and, you know, try and get it together. But I got to start applying to colleges. I've taken my SAT 2 times this last time. Like, I'm done taking the SAT. If I didn't do good this last time, scores come out tomorrow. We're going to see. But, yeah, I'm just, you know, just ready to start, you know, whatever. But I have some very big stuff coming for 2019, you guys. Like, it's crazy. I feel like after this semester is over, which is so stressful, it's going to be smooth sailing. Like, I finished my econ, which is a mandatory class that I take. It's only a half a year class, but that's really what's stressful, you know, and that's only half a year, so it ends this December. We take our ELC, and pretty much the rest of my classes are like BS the next semester, so I should be able to put out more content, and soccer season's gonna start. I'm gonna have some soccer vlogs, practice vlogs, all that for you guys, so... yeah, 2019 is going to be hella lit, and my goal is to get 100K before January is over with, so hopefully we get there, you know. Maybe I might get there Christmas break when I'm putting out all these videos, because I'm not going to do Vlogmas, but I'm going to do, like, Breakmas or something. It's weird. I'm not going to do Vlogmas because I couldn't produce 25 videos. I just couldn't, not with my schedule, but... yeah, I'm probably going to try and do something big over the break, you know, something like videos like every other day, you know, if not, you know, every day, every other day. So, we're going to see. And most definitely, I'm doing a Christmas Day vlog, so y'all going to get that. Basically, I'm just going to look at these pictures and read off what y'all said to me. And so, one girl, advice for video, and everything is kept anonymous. Advice for video. Please keep my name anonymous. She's put anonymous wrong. It's so cute. So, I'm currently dating this boy. We've been dating 6 months, about to be 7. So, I want him to meet my mom and dad, but I'm quite young. 15 turning 16 in April. But I don't know how to tell them. I got a boyfriend and I want you to meet him. I'm not asking for him to spend the night or nothing. I hate lying to my parents where I'm going. Like, we went to the movie about 2 weeks ago, and I told them I was going with my friends, which isn't fully lying because one of my friends was also going, but can you help me? Okay, I wouldn't say I can, like, fully relate, but I can in a way because I've always been kind of awkward with my parents about, like, boyfriends and stuff. But basically what I would do is just tell them, you know, even if you don't say my boyfriend, you can just be like, I have a guy friend. You know, and, you know, we like each other. It's nothing major, you know. It's even if it's, you know, just don't, you know, make it more than what it is. Because parents are very, like, extra when it comes to stuff like that. So just, like, be like, I have a guy friend and he wants to go to movies or whatever. And I feel like 15, going on 16. 15 is kind of young. What grade was I in when I was 15? I was in 10th grade. I'm 17 now. I was 16 in 11th grade. 15, you're in 10th grade, and by the time you hit high school, you're pretty mature, you pretty much know what you want and how to handle certain situations. So I feel like just going on a date night to the movies or something shouldn't be bad, and I feel like your parents should understand that, and also they should understand that by, you know, hindering your ability to be able to talk to them will create sneakiness. And so if you don't feel comfortable coming to your parents about stuff, then you will eventually become sneaky. So, you know, make sure you open up and tell them the truth. Like, don't go somewhere. And also, when you go to the movies, say you go to the movies, but they think you're with your friend, but you're with a guy friend. You really want your parents to know at all times where you're going, even if you know you're not. Like, I just feel like it's a certain level of trust, respect, and, you know, that should come with a relationship like that. So try to ease it on them. I mean, I'm sure they don't think you're just going through life without interaction with dudes. So they're going to know something is going on. You know, you have something going on with somebody. But at the end of the day, it's your life. They can't, you know, try and keep you from, you know, what's life. This is life. This is how you live. You got to live and you got to learn stuff. And by you being afraid to talk to them and, you know, shying away from it, you never know the outcome. You know, some people feel like their parents are more stricter than what they are and are afraid to tell them things. And some parents don't even, like, be tripping like that once you tell them. They're more mad at the fact that you don't feel comfortable enough telling them things so they can know. So just try and ease it on them. And, you know, I feel like once someone meets your parents, it's more easier for you guys to communicate, interact, etc., you know, go places. Because if your parents, you know, have a feel for the individual and they're not just, you know, thinking of a mystery person, you know, they're able to actually grasp an idea of who this person is, who their daughter is around, etc. So just keep that in mind and don't try and hide it. You know, that's the worst thing you can do is try to hide it. You know, just try to be more open and let them know. And you never know the outcome, you know. I used to be the same way. I used to be like, I don't want to, you know. But at the end of the day, you're growing up. You're 15 going on 16. You're about to be a junior in high school. You pretty much know what you want. And they can't stop you from, it's life, you know, dealing with opposite gender. So just try to ease it on them, girl. Let me know how it works out. If you say, someone said, I need some advice. I just went through a breakup and I don't understand how they moved on so fast. And it's like, I'm hurt deep down, but I don't show anybody and I don't want them to know. I tell everybody I'm okay, but low-key my feelings a little hurt and the breakup came out of nowhere and I was in love with this dude. He told me to, he loved me and everything. I honestly just don't know what to do now. Well, number one, these dudes be lying. Let's keep it a buck. They be lying. So, and even, I mean, at the time and place of when they said it, they might not have been lying. But you got to realize that we're all young here. We're all, you know, teenagers. And just because you feel something one minute don't mean you're going to feel it the next. You know what I'm saying? We evolving, changing, still ain't reached our full potential yet. Never haven't experienced something, haven't experienced different people. And just because you feel like you may feel like this one time, like one minute, you may not feel like it the next. So I feel like as far as relationships when you're young, you have to be more cautious. You know what I'm saying? And even though he did move on fast, you know, don't think it's something to do with you. It's just some people get over situations quicker. Some people don't. It depends. Sometimes it may just depend on the situation how fast you get over it. But don't dwell on it, you know? And I know you probably were in love, but it's like, you probably young and you probably even like, I don't know how to say it. I feel like my mentality is different than everybody's, but at the end of the day, the chances are slim to none that he was going to be your husband. So I don't want you to feel like, dang, like he, you know, whatever. It's okay to be hurt, but at a certain point, it's like, we still young here. So you live and you learn, and you know, lose one, you gonna bounce back with FOMO, sis. Just post a picture. That's my advice, baby, because, baby, same thing happened to me not too long ago. And dude was with a girl in the next day, literally. And you know what I did? I bounced back with, like, 8 of them, period. Like, it don't even be that deep. Like, I be caring, but you gotta know who you are to, you know, I feel like it takes a strong person to get over situations like that. Like, you gotta know who you are deep down to know that when somebody does you wrong, at the end of the day, you still gonna be you. At the end of the day, you still gonna get who you wanna get. And at the end of the day, you still lit. Like, you can't let other people affect your aura. And if he He see something next door that he like better, let him go next door. You don't, you know, think nothing wrong with you, you know, just, you know, it's life. It happens to all of us, and, you know, it may take time, but at the end of the day, just know you still that bitch, period. Okay, this is another one. This is going to be long, but I'm going to try to make it a little shorter. I'm 16. In the morning when I'm supposed to be on the bus, I've been having this dude I talked to. Woo, he's 20. Pick me up. We would go to his place and chill and do stuff for a while. Then, what is do stuff? Hold on, sis. Hold on. You got me a little bit. You grown. Anyways, he would bring me to school. I would usually be about 30 minutes to 2 hours late each time. One day, my parents ended up realizing that I didn't ride the bus, and they asked me about it. So, I came clean and told them. Thankfully, they didn't press charges. They only talked to his parents and him about the situation and told him not to talk to me anymore. I'm punished now, and it's very, very sad because I've actually been through a situation similar to this before with them. That week they found out my dad was going to surprise me with a car that he bought. I have to wait until they trust me to get the car, and I basically can't get anything or do anything. How can I try to gain their trust and do better? Okay, first of all, you shouldn't be 16 years old with no 20-year-old. I don't care. At least if, I feel like if you gotta sneak and do it, you don't got no business doing it, period. So that's just point blank. If you know your parents was gonna feel some type of way, you shouldn't even been doing it, period. Because I feel like if you living under their roof, under their rules, you gotta abide by them. That's just life. And so, you know, you never know what your parents have for you. Like, sometimes we block our own blessings by, you know, being disrespectful or neglecting to appreciate what our parents do for us. And they had a whole car for you, but yet you out here sneaking and geeking. So, you know what I'm saying? You gotta... And it goes back to the being more open with your parents thing. You shouldn't been sneaking. Like, if you got to sneak and do it, then you know you have no business doing it, period. When you turn, I feel like 16, that's kind of young. Maybe if you were 17, it would be kind of lenient, but that's 4 years. I feel like a 20-year-old shouldn't want nothing to do with no 16-year-old. And I was 16, I had people trying to talk to me, but I feel like that's weird. I don't know. I feel like that's weird. Like, in the real world, when you get older and stuff, and you're like 20, 24, you know, 24, 28, it's nothing. But I feel like we kids, like, what a 20-year-old want with a girl that's in high school, you know? I don't know. That's weird to me. But, girl, I don't know what to say. In order to gain their trust back, just chill, like, for a minute. Just, you know, focus on your grades. You know, being on books, show them more responsibility. Help her out running the house, maybe get a job or something. You know, show them that you actually trying. So, you know, or whatever. And just explain to them more in depth of the situation, you know. I don't know. I can't really. Just 30 minutes to 2 hours late each day. Girl, 30 minutes to 2 hours? What was y'all doing? And you said we was doing stuff. What was y'all doing? He 20 years, that's statutory rape, for real. Ain't even funny. I don't know. I know I would never pull no stunt like that. I'm just not the type of person. I don't feel the need to sneak anything I do my parents know about. So, I mean, that's just that. But 30 to 2 hours, that's a lot missing school for a boy that probably ain't got... Not to be rude, but if you 20 years old and you got 30 minutes to 2 hours to go pick up a 16-year-old girl and take her away from school, you don't have a life. That's how I feel. Because I know somebody in a situation, but I know somebody close to a situation like that. And I just feel like, what you doing that you got all that time? Like, why you ain't got no job? Why you not in school? You know, and I feel like me personally, he's probably in, I don't know the dude and I don't know the situation, but I just feel like, he probably wasn't no good anyway, so. But that's out of my hands, yeah. So, I don't know about it, but that's just how I feel. He probably wasn't no good anyway, so. They probably saved you from a, you know, destructive situation. But, yeah. So, just stay cool, you know. You just help out, you know, focus on your grades. And just, it gotta build it back up, because you broke it. So, and trust is, it takes 1 second to break trust and forever to build it up, so. You know, but next, I need advice on a situation. There's this boy, he was a grade above me, and he graduated 2 years ago, and I graduated last year, and we're both in college now. We have somewhat of a history. He was the very first person I ever had feelings for, and they were very strong. I never spoke up and decided to date other people because I thought he didn't feel the same way. Two summers ago, I found out that he had feelings for me as well, but he too didn't speak up. We've been talking ever since as friends, and we often reminisce over what could have been. We're not together, but we tell each other everything, and he's one of my closest friends. He helps me with my relationship issues and vice versa. Right now, we're both single, and I think my feelings are starting to develop again, or my feelings for him never left. He said he really wanted to link over the break, and made it seem like he really wanted to see me, but he flaked. And when I called him out on it, he didn't text me back. And now I don't know what to do. From a subscriber, you make great content. Keep up the good work. Okay, I kind of have a situation with somebody like that. Like, we have feelings for each other, but we never really, like, did anything about it. And so, like, we always be that person that we can always talk to each other about certain situations. But how I see it is, maybe, like, I want to know, like, the whole backstory. Do y'all go to the same college? Because if not, it's probably a situation where he has a situation going on, but he still, you know, oh my God. Probably has a situation going on. And, probably still unsure about how he feels about you. So, that's probably what it is. I mean, the fact that he didn't text back, he probably encountered somebody that he had some type of dealings with. And so, he's just trying to, you know, shy away from you. But at the end of the day, y'all are just friends. And, you know, he'll come back around eventually. I mean, that's weird that he flaked. But at the end of the day, y'all weren't anything more than friends. Y'all talked about y'all relationships together and stuff like that. So, just try and, you know, hit him up again or whatever. And just be like, you know, what's up? What's good? And hopefully he, you know, comes around and, you know, lets you know. But just pretty much let him know how you feel, because a lot of times you don't let people know what's going on in your head, and so they don't know. People aren't mind readers, and people expect people to know things that they don't say. And so if you're not letting him know that's how you feel, then maybe he has another situation on the side that's pending, but he waiting on you to push up, but you're not. So I don't know, that's a tough situation. Just let him know how you feel. And if he doesn't respond, then it may be not what he wants, you know? That's just what it is. That's life. But, yeah. But anyways, yeah, if you guys want to see more, like, little segments like that where y'all, you know, text me and let me know, like, what's going on in your life and I talk about it in the video, then let me know. It's going to be, I want to make it, like, a small segment that I do, like, once a week or something like that just to help people out. But, yeah, that's basically it for this video. You guys, make sure you go get your Beauty Forever hair, y'all. It's popping. It's lit. So, I washed it from the last video. Some girl made me mad. She's talking about, that's four bundles. That look more like two. First of all, sis, pause. Slow your roll. It's more like four. I added the fourth bundle. And you got to think about, when you got 30 inches of hair and 28 inches, you need a lot of bundles anyway. Four at least. You know what I'm saying? Five, you know, five, six at max. So, I ain't trying to hear none of that. I don't like no big old wiggy head anyway, so na 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 boo boo. But I don't care. I don't really be tripping off what nobody got to say. But yeah. But can we talk about how YouTube keeps copyrighting my stuff? Like, what's good? For real. Because they keep on copyrighting my videos. And I don't appreciate having to share profit, period. So, you know, I don't know what I'm gonna do, but or whatever, but I got like three videos that's been copyrighted already, so I don't know. They don't play when it comes to that, especially Sony Digital and stuff like that with their music. Even if it's an instrumental, they don't be playing, so I gotta watch out with that, because I just like my music. Like, I like the vibe of my videos when I have a music in the background. Like, I just feel like it brings the entire video to life. But I mean, it's like copyright infringement is real, and you can't take nobody's music, period. So I'm gonna have to figure out how to work around that or whatever, or to get me some music. But Yeah, guys, like I said, y'all go get y'all Beauty Forever hair. This is a straight texture, and I washed it, and I put a little curls in it. I let it air dry, so I didn't flat iron it after I air dried, and it had a little wave to it, but I just put some curls into it, so it's pretty thick now, as opposed to my last video. She gave me, the girl, she might have talked trash, but she gave me motivation to put some more hair in my head, because I knew I was looking a little crazy, but it's okay. Anyways, I hope to film a video both Saturday and Sunday, hopefully. Hopefully. Let's cross our fingers, y'all. Because I ain't gonna lie, I be getting lazy. And I be like, forget it. But we have a game Saturday, so I might do a game day vlog. But, yeah, that's pretty much it. If you like what you've seen, please like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in the next video.